Sunday we went to a church service they had, and usually when I go to like church in America, it's like, oh, I have to wake up. It was so full. I've never seen a more packed church service, and everyone was like dancing and like they were just so excited to be there, and I've never seen that kind of excitement.
Most people in China had never seen an American before, and so every time we went to a public place, you'd see people like kind of like trying to sneak like take pictures with us. And they come up to us and ask us like if we knew who like LeBron James was and if we'd met him before.
Smaller groups, and my group, we were sent to the Bridges route, and just out of Tent City we saw this guy with a copy of the New Testament, and we went to talk to him. One of our members had given it to him, and what was great was on that last day, Friday, he came with us to the last meeting, and he decided to come off the streets and, you know, follow God.
They have such a unified Christian community. And I mean, like, I'd be just brushing my teeth and I can still hear them praising God in the shower. It was just cool stuff like that.
Praying with the people of the community, we would go and hand out lunches to them, but even more than the lunches, like, most of them said yes, we wanted to pray with them, and it seemed to like that was the part that they appreciated the most, and just seeing the power of prayer in the people, it was incredible.
When we went out and we found these two girls under the bridges, and all they had was like some cardboard, a sleeping bag, and a doll, and to them that was the only life they had ever.
God is light, in him there is no darkness at all. 1 John 1, 4-6.
When you fall asleep tonight, in your warm and cozy room, know that I'm awake and I've got no shelter and no food. And I am not alone. My friends are broken, lost, looking for.
I'm going back to Haiti and Ecuador this year. In Ecuador, it was just, we built great relationships with the kids at the Verbo School and with the Compassion International Lunch Clubs. And I just can't wait to see them again this year.
I need your help. Won't you be my voice calling? Won't you be my head?
won't you be my feet walking into a broken world? Won't you be my chain breaker? Won't you be my peacemaker? Won't you be my hope and joy? Won't you be my love? The other side of the world, she's just a few days old. A helpless little girl with no family of her own. She is not to blame for the journey she is on.
When we met this family who was staying in the church while we were doing VBS, and one of the little girls in the family would come to VBS every day, and we really got to know her. And at the end of the week, we came back to the church to drop food off for them and baby supplies, but they weren't there. And so we went to go find them, but all we knew was the name of the street. So we kept walking up and down the street just yelling the little girl's name. And finally, somebody came out from one of the balconies, and it was their family. We went up to deliver the supplies, and they were like so happy.
We're going back to Cozumel this year because we had a wonderful time and we built great relationships with the children down there.
In him was life, and that life was the light of men.
Ben Joy, won't you be my love? To those I call my own, to those spotless without blame, the chosen.
We got to go visit one of their inner sanctum places where they have worships and, you know, their equivalent to worship. And it's where they went after the Kachina dance. We didn't get to go see in there because we're not Hopi, but it was still cool. We got a sort of a private tour by one of the Hopis himself, and it was just a really cool experience.
Last year, we gave up lunch one day and fasted and gave our food to the village, the people in the village. And we almost ran out of food, but then we prayed about it and asked God to let him provide. And then we had more than enough food for everyone in the village.
It's definitely relieving. Like, you work a whole week trying to help this village, and just leaving, you feel like you're not finished and you want to keep doing something. So it's really cool.
You are my lamp, O Lord. The Lord turns my darkness into light. 2 Samuel 22:28-30.
Tried my way. the plans you made. I never thought that I could ever learn to let it go. Somehow it's better when I'm following the paths you show. So I'm here, I'm waiting, 'cause I believe. Some say we need a miracle.
Is when you've gone a previous year and you're just sitting on that bus waiting to get off, waiting to see those kids, and you're just hoping that one of those kids will remember you, that one of them will come give you a hug. And then you just get off and four or five kids run up to you and they just shout your name and they're hugging you and everything. And that out of the hundreds of people they've seen every year, that they remember you because you've just made an impact on their lives.
One of the kids that I had built a relationship with the previous year saw me outside the window and ran outside and to just give me a hug. And it just meant a lot that he remembered me even though I hadn't seen him in over a year.
Connected to the kids was through them teaching me the language, learning Haitian Creole. They would teach me all these funny phrases or jokes I could ask different people, and then when we would go like to the beach, they would tell me to go up to like a random person and ask them the joke and tell them the joke, and they would just start laughing, and it was just so much fun. When we were down there, it was playing basketball with all the kids there, teaching us the language and learning a language we've never even heard of before. It just helped to like make connections, and I'm hoping to reestablish them and make them stronger.
For with you is the fountain of life. In your light, we see light. Psalms 36, 8 through 10.
Don't have a job, don't pay your bills, won't buy you a home in Beverly Hills.
A really hard part of Kenya is like going back and realizing that I was only there a week, and then I got to go back to like normal life and like getting a shower every day and normal food, and just that they've been living in those same conditions all year and they never get a break from it. They're always out in the hot, like they don't always get a shower, they're not always like getting every meal.
And there was this little girl and she was asking me to like read her a part in the Bible about Jesus and his miracles. She was just like so excited about it, and like it was really encouraging for me because it made me want, like, because she was like so excited about it, it made me be more excited about like telling her about like Jesus and stuff. Waiting for you. One day, and the chef there used to live on the street and he used to hang out by a grocery store, and he said that he would ask every day for just a cracker or something that from a person who shopped there, and he said every day no one gave him anything. And so I just, that really showed me that even the littlest things are so important in life.
You build relationships with all the kids, and then they move up to a different grade, so you're not guaranteed to see them when you go back, and you just really miss them a lot when you come home.
In the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father in heaven. Matthew 5, 15-17.
you move, I'll move, I will follow.
The best part of Namibia is just seeing those kids smile. Like, you go and you see where they live, and then just to see them smile and come play with you and want to play tag, and like you feel like you're making a difference in their life for just that one day, and to like ease the pain a little and let them forget about what they have to go home to, it just makes it worth it. And like, I haven't been able to see this little girl I became close with in 3 years, and she writes me a Christmas card every year. So you know that you like make an impact and you can really change something.
Light into the world, light into my life. I will live for you alone. You're the one I seek, knowing I will find all I need in you alone. In you alone. Where you go, I'll go.
Once you go to Africa, you just can't not go back, and the kids there just leave like a handprint on your heart, and you just want April to come faster so you can come back and see them.
You are the light of the world. A city on a hill cannot be hidden. Matthew 5:13-15.
Kids came up to me, her name's Michelle, and she just had tears like starting to come in her eyes, and she came up and hugged me, and it was really hard to say goodbye. And I think it just made me, you know, want to stay like an extra week there. That was definitely the hardest part for me.
I love how you serve.